Okay, let's look at the Wolff-Kisner reduction. So the Wolff-Kisner, like the Clemmenson reduction and like the Mozingo reaction, reduce a carbonyl to a methylene unit, or CH2. We're going to involve a hydrazone intermediate, and the irreversible loss of nitrogen gas is what drives this reaction to completion. So we're going to treat the carbonyl, the ketone, with hydrazine and hydroxide base and a little bit of acid here, heat. So if we look at the mechanism, the attack to the carbonyl is the first step by hydrazine. Form this intermediate, which is whose proton, the extra proton on nitrogen, is quickly scavenged up by hydroxide to form this intermediate. An additional proton exchange with the formed water. Can form that hydroxyl group there. And allow me to highlight this bond, nitrogen to hydrogen. I'm going to use the hydroxide we just formed to form the hydrazone. Again, highlighting one of these hydrogen to nitrogen bonds. We generated more hydroxide with that elimination. You can deprotonate, form a double bond nitrogen to nitrogen, and form a carbanion here. Now some accounts say that this occurs in conjunction with deprotonation of water. We'll show it as two separate steps here for our purposes. And so this can then deprotonate water that we just formed and we're halfway there. Again, highlight that bond to nitrogen. We just form more hydroxide. Deprotonate once again. This step is driven by elimination of nitrogen gas, so it's actually irreversible. We'll get rid of those equilibrium arrows. Carbanion forms, nitrogen gas leaves. And then one additional proton exchange again, the pKa's of these two are so different, we don't expect reversibility, and we get our methylene unit.